Subscriber of mine already, then you know that this video is a little bit different than what you're used to. We usually do vlogs and that sort of thing, but I do like to throw in a mommy related video every now and then just to switch it up. And I've had a lot of people recently ask me how I wear both babies at the same time. I'm like so out of breath because I just was trying to get them settled. The babies are right here in front of me, so if you hear noises, that's why they're in their rockin' plays. And anyway, so yeah, I figured I would show you guys how I use two ergos to carry both of my 9-month-old baby boys when we are out at the grocery store or just running errands or that sort of thing. And if you are new to our channel, if this is the first video you're seeing, please maybe take a second to go look at our other videos after you're done with this one. We do vlogging most of the time. We vlog our life with twins and a 2.5-year-old. So we would love to have you join our Webb fam by clicking that subscribe button if that's something that you would like to do. But anyway, before they start losing their mind, let's go ahead and jump into this. First safety tip is your babies should have good head control before you attempt wearing a baby on your back. A lot of people say they should be sitting up on their own, but my boys, like if you sit them up, they'll sit up on their own, but they're not actually like doing it themselves. They were premature, so they're about 7.5 months adjusted. So yeah, make sure your baby has really great head control before you try putting them on your back. So usually I do this at the back of my van so I can sit down, but I'm pretty experienced with this. I still carry my toddler in one of these sometimes because she hasn't hit the maximum weight requirement for the Ergo baby carrier. But yeah, just make sure you read your owner's manual and go through all of the safety precautions. So we got this one for our baby shower, and at the very end of this video, I'm gonna go over some tips and tricks on your Ergo baby, things that you probably didn't know, that I didn't necessarily know until I learned it along the way of using it. So anyway, I like to use this one for my back carry because it's the newest and I just feel like it's the safest, even though all Ergo babies are safe and secure, but this one is newer, so I just feel more comfortable having it on my back. This is the original baby Ergo, and I am the, I think, third owner of this. I bought this off of a friend a while back, so this is much older, but it still gets the job done. So I'm going to show you how to carry the babies now. Before you get started, if you have long hair like me, I suggest putting it up in a bun. You will thank me later because these guys like to rip my hair out. So let's do that real quick. Okay. Now that that's out of the way. Now, I have identical twin boys, but I do have a smaller twin. Now, I recommend that you put your bigger baby on your back just because usually the bigger baby is a little bit further along and like holding their head up better and stuff like that. So I usually try to make sure to put my biggest baby on my back, which is my son, Jameson. Take your Ergo baby and make sure that you loosen the straps a little bit all around. I usually haven't loosened the underarm straps. And if you're gonna do a back carry, you wanna go ahead and make sure you have the arm straps pretty loose. And I usually start off center, so about here. And make sure that you loop your clip through the safety belt. If you didn't know what that elastic was for, it's in case it comes undone, it's gonna catch. And then clip it together. So it's pretty loose here. I might want it to be a little bit tighter. You just wanna be able to slide easily. So I can still slide that pretty easily. And then you are going to grab your baby.
Can I hold you? Can I hold you for a second?
So this is Jameson. He is 9 months old today and he weighs roughly 20 pounds. So I am going to put him on my side here.
Can you say hi?
And then I'm going to pull this up over his back to give him a good seat like this. You wanna make sure that it's pretty far up. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to pull these two straps together, like so. So I'm gonna pull both of the arm straps together. I don't know if you could see that. I'm gonna bend him over. So both arm straps are gonna come together and I'm gonna hold them like this. So he's not going anywhere, right? Like his head is here, he's not choking. I can put my hand through here. He's not choking, but he's safe, right? So then you're kinda gonna twist around to your back, and then you're going to loop your opposite arm into the armhole, and then you're gonna bend over and kind of jump him around. Put your arm in. And then you jump your baby around to where you've got him up pretty high and comfortable. Tighten your belt. It's gonna be real cute. You're gonna have a mom pouch, but you know what? It's okay, you carried a baby, so. And then I'm going to pull these tight, and then I'm gonna clip them in, and I'm gonna tighten this. And I'm just gonna bounce until I'm comfortable. So you have your first baby in. You wanna make sure that not one leg is extended too far. Sometimes he's off center in the seat. You wanna make sure that you've got him in the seat really well. If you need to adjust, you can always put your arm in and try to scoot him over a little bit. But you wanna make sure that their knees can bend and that they're in a good seated position. Comfortable back there? Okay, so baby number one is in. Now, I'm gonna readjust myself here. All right, make sure I'm all comfortable. It's your turn, Now, to layer your ergos, you're gonna grab your second ergo. And this time you're going to center your belt and you are going to loop under your baby's foot. Make sure you're under your baby's foot. Go back through that safety strap here and clip. Now, you should be able to kiss the top of your baby's head. So I like to make sure my ergos are up pretty high, right around my belly button region. Ooh, girlfriend is sweating. Now, I didn't say this wasn't a lot of work, but you know what? It saves my sanity at the grocery store. I'm locked in. We are tight here. You're not gonna have to do any spinning or anything, so you wanna go ahead and have this tight. And go ahead and loosen your arm straps because you don't wanna be all stuck. And by loosening your arm straps, you could just look here. You just pull up to loosen. It's pretty self-explanatory. Now I'm gonna grab baby number two. Come here. Hi. This is Jacob, little Jacob. This is my smaller baby. He weighs about 19 pounds, so he's just about a pound lighter, but he's just a little bit smaller all around. And then I'm just going to seat him. You want to make sure that they have a good seat and that their legs are in an M shape. I'm gonna pull this up over his back, make sure he has a good seat by bouncing him in. And then I'm going to simply put my arms in. I'm gonna grab my clips in the back here and snap them together and tighten. And then I'm gonna pull him close to me, if he'll let me. I'm gonna pull him in close to me, grab my arm straps and tighten. Same on this side. Grab my arm strap and tighten in. And now we're in. And now you can go about your business at the grocery store. They're comfortable. They can play footsie over here. And then they are both in a good seat. Yeah? You feel good? Now if they fall asleep, you can always reach around and grab your hood. You can always snap the hood on. People always look at me weird when I do this because they're like, oh, you're suffocating your baby. You're not, they can breathe. Ergo baby wouldn't come out with something that was going to harm your baby. So no worries there. And then we can put these on. My daughter calls this the hat. My babies really love this. They feel really comfortable. I feel super balanced. I don't feel like one baby's weighing me back. I don't feel like one's weighing me too much forward. So it's really comfortable. If these straps are bothering you, I'm gonna show you how to fix that in just a minute. So that is how you get your babies into the Ergo carrier for a tandem wear. What do you think about that? You like it? And then I'm gonna show you how I take them out. So to take the babies out, this is something people ask me about all the time. Like, how do you get the one on your back off? Because this one's really easy. So to take the front baby off, which is your first baby, it's the Ergo that's on top, you're just going to unsnap and pull your arm out. You've got your hand here for support the whole time. Yeah, dad, we know. Pull your other arm out here, hand under the arm, hand under the other arm, and you're free. Yes, you will. So baby number one is out. I'm going to undo this side. Ergo is off. You just unclip it on the side and it comes right off. This baby is a little bit more tricky. I usually have to sit down on my trunk to get him out. And I don't have to do it, it's just I feel more comfortable doing it that way, but this will work just fine. So we loosen your chest strap just by simply pulling like this. Loosen your arm straps. This is when you're gonna wanna start bending over because you don't want them to get too loose and fall over. He just threw up on my back. It's okay, we'll keep going. I'm going to unclip and then pull this arm out, but I'm still gonna hold on here. And then I'm going to pull it over my back like this and grab it with this hand. So I'm holding both of them again. I've got him in that nice choke hold, if you will. I'm not choking him. Then I'm going to loosen my bottom strap here so I can slide. And then I'm going to pull him around, grab him with my arm, pull my arm through.
Hi.
I've got him now. And same thing as before. I'm gonna use my knee. I'm going to just get him out.
There you go. And you're free and happy.
So yeah, and that, my friends, is how you put a baby in and take a baby out of an ergo and how you tandem wear babies. I have to lock them in. I need a better system because they're starting to get out, and Jameson, the one that was on my back, he likes to eat the dog food. Yay. Okay, now I'm gonna show you some tips and tricks that you may or may not have known with your ergo. So first is how to fold your ergo. A lot of people don't know that you can actually fold your ergo nice and neat, and I'm gonna show you how to do that really quick. First, I would just tighten your straps down, your shoulder pad straps down like this. And you can keep your hood on the inside. I don't know if you've noticed that these have a pretty good bend. So you just want to fold these straps together like this, and then fold one over here, and then begin rolling your ergo down. Just keep rolling, just keep rolling, just keep rolling. Then you're gonna take this side here, and then your belt clip over here, and you are going to clip them together like this, and then simply pull to tighten, and your ergo is folded all nice and neat for easy packing. I could easily put this in my diaper bag. Another thing, number two, that you may not have noticed is the little elastic here on the end of your straps. I used to just think these were like for babies to chew on, which is ridiculous, right? So really, in reality, what it is once you have your baby on, especially if you're a really petite person, you're gonna have a lot of slack at the end of this rope after you put your baby on. So if it bothers you, like it bothers some people, you're gonna want to start rolling your strap. Just start, keep rolling it all the way until you've got enough slack. Okay, so we're rolled up, right? Then you are simply going to take this and loop it over. See there? Now it's all nice and neat, right? My camera starts shaking a bit. It's the boys. And you can do that with all of them. Even these little baby straps have that elastic piece. You can just roll it all the way down and then loop your elastic piece over. These little ones are a little bit more difficult. There you go. And it's all nice and secure. I didn't realize, I thought this puppy here was simply a phone pocket. And so that's where I keep my phone. But I mean, it has a zipper on the side, so that's where you can keep your phone and keys, whatever. You can put your phone there, works great. Okay, but it's actually to store the hood. So all you have to do is roll this puppy up like so, and tuck it in there if it gets on your nerves, which some people don't like it hanging. I personally don't care, but it just looks much neater this way. When you front carry, you want your clip to be up higher so that you can reach it better back up here. So usually your clip is gonna be like up here if you're front carrying. And then when I put this on, when I was gonna do a back carry, it was like legitimately choking me, right? It was like up here in my throat, and I was like, what the heck, ergo? No, it was more like, what the heck, Kayla, read your manual. It actually slides down for comfort. so that when you're back carrying, it's down here and not up at your neck. But yeah, that is all I have for this Ergobaby demo and tips and tricks and hacks for you today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it was a little bit different. I have babies crawling around me all over the place, so if you hear noises or you saw the camera shaking or anything like that, I'm so sorry. Like right now, little Jacob is messing with my tripod, and here comes Jameson. But anyway, thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. If you liked what you saw, please be sure to give me a big thumbs up. It really helps me out. And if you would like to, please join our Webb fam by hitting that subscribe button and clicking the notification bell beside it so that you can get notified when I do upload. We usually do family vlogs, but on the rare occasion, I do like to throw a mommy video like this in there. So again, hope you enjoyed what you saw, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye!